So Māyā also means that which plays.
So Māyā hides the truth.
Yes.
And projects a false virtual reality.
Right.
That kind of thing.
Right.
So it's like if I put on virtual reality goggles, one part is that I can't see what is really there.
Right.
Because the goggles are blocking the real thing.
Right.
And then the goggles are playing a movie, and I'm supposed to be in that virtual
You're
world.
You're part of that.
I'm part of that. So two things have happened. One is blocking what is real, and secondly, projecting some unreal narrative, some story, some fantasy, some whatever vision.
Right.
So Māyā has both these purposes.
These two functions.
These two
and functions. Then the interesting thing is that Māyā cannot perform these two functions without the support of Bhagavan. Because illusion is always rooted in reality.
Right.
Because if there is no reality, there cannot be an illusion.
Right.
So Māyā ultimately has its support in Bhagavan. And therefore, if you want to get rid of this Māyā, then you have to take shelter of Bhagavan. So that's why Krishna says very categorically in Bhagavad Gita, he says, Devi hiyesa gunamayi mama Māyā durateya. He says that this Māyā is made of three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas, which prakriti is another word we use
right,
for
right.
that. Devi hiyesa gunamayi, it is called Devi, means it is actually playing. The children, we are like the children. And we are playing with these material objects like toys, you know. So you keep on playing with that and you don't realize that actually your real father is Bhagavan. And that's where you belong to.
So are we? Can we say that the whole world as Māyā, well, like they sometimes say, the world as we see.
What does Bhagavan mean?
Means part
Bhagavan is an epithet for God, such as avatars of Vishnu in Vaishnavism and Shiva in the Shaivism tradition of Hinduism. The term denotes the absolute truth or the supreme being manifested as a personal God. It is this personal feature which differentiates the word from other similar terms, such as Brahman, which is absolute reality or the supreme spirit. Neither the Vedic texts nor the early and middle Upanishads mention or explain the word Bhagavan. It is first found in later era literature, such as the Bhagavad Gita and the Puranas, where Ishvara or God is called Bhagavan, and the person consecrated to Bhagavan is called a Bhagavata. In some sects, the term is used as an honorific title for a spiritual leader considered fully enlightened by the section. It is also used in yoga to refer to certain yogis.
And the only way to get out of illusion is to take shelter in Bhagavan.
Right.
That is not part of the illusion idea.
Right.
So that's one way it's different.
That's very important difference.
Very important difference.
Because you don't know how you can get out of this illusion.
Yeah, yeah. And then the other difference is, I'm not sure the word illusion includes that both there is some kind of a delusion to cover up the reality, and then there is the actual projection of a false reality. I don't think the two are clearly separated when they talk about...
Yeah, when people are speaking, they're not very clear what they mean by it.
So Māyā is a person,
right?
A personality with the structure of these two components, a plan... there's a whole system that's working. Māyā is a whole system. Whereas illusion doesn't convey any of this.
Yeah, really speaking, if you want to go into more detail, Māyā has got two parts in it. One is called Jiva Māyā.
Okay.
Other is called Guna Māyā.
Okay.
So Guna Māyā is that which I said that externally through the gunas, it creates the universe.
Right.
And Jiva Māyā is which I was talking about, that it is covering
the idea of who I am.
Who you are, and then making you think all this external world in a wrong sense, not recognizing the reality behind it.
So it is actually a false self, conceptualized self, looking at a false reality being projected, and this is the dance that's going on.
Right, and then the study which you are doing of this world is also using the product.
Yogapedia explains Bhagavan. Bhagavan is generally translated to mean Lord or God, but it literally means fortunate or blessed. Some texts define Bhagavan as the one who has the Bhaga or majesty. Bhaga is described as having six qualities: dominion, might, glory, splendor, wisdom, and dispassion. Some slight variations of the qualities listed can be found in different texts. Although everyone can claim to possess some degree of these qualities, only the supreme personality of the Godhead can claim them all absolutely. Bhagavan, Brahman, and Paramatma, the supersoul, are the three pillars of the absolute truth. It is stated that unless one understands all these features of the absolute truth, one's knowledge is imperfect.
It is also said that the seekers of Brahman are called jnana yogis, while those whose goal is paramatma are called yogis.
And seeking/knowing the Bhagavan is a privilege of bhakti yogis or devotees. Nowadays, it is customary to address yogis or spiritual gurus and masters as Bhagavan, as a sign of honor and profound respect.
Sometimes it is claimed wrong to address someone as God, but others claim it is perfectly normal in Hindu traditions.
So we have to understand that.
So Māyā is real because it's an aspect of Bhagavan.
Right.
But what it is doing to us, how we are thinking of the world, of ourselves and the world, that is the...
That is not ultimately real.
That is not ultimately real.
Right.
Wonderful. This is very nice. Yes. Thank you. Namaste.